Can we just all come together real quick and just make fun of somebody for a moment?
Sure.
Let's just cleanse the palate. It's been a serious news day. You guys need a break, right? Let's all hate somebody together. All of us. Without any kind of question, let's all get on. Let's have some unity, okay? We got to talk about these biohacking freaks. This is, I don't know if I want to laugh or roll. I don't know what I want to do. This is so weird. Have you heard about, first off, there was the dude. How old is he? He's like in his 50s. And he's like, I want to be like as biologically young as my son. Right? And he like, it sounds like he kind of uses his kid as a guinea pig. He's like, I take my son's blood and I run tests and then I do. And he's like, from what I understand, that guy who started this biohacking thing, he looks silver. He looks weird. All I can tell is that he grew his hair out, got a ton of Botox, and maybe dipped himself in colloidal silver. I don't know. I don't really notice much of a difference, right? He still looks the same age. Sure, I'll go ahead. If you want to tell me that you think that you're biologically 19, okay, I really don't care. I don't know you. I'm not going to send you flowers when you die. I don't care. I won't even know when you die. I won't even be notified because we don't know each other. So I don't care. So I just, you know, I do what you want to do in your own life. But now it's a big thing. I've got to talk about this story. So now it's like the new CrossFit. Everybody's biohacking, guys. Everybody. And it's starting to be stretched from, here's a freak rich dude who's like injecting all this weird stuff into him. And now it's like just people eating healthy, just like they're biohacking. Oh my gosh, that's insufferable. So we all agree that people who do CrossFit talk all the damn time about CrossFit, right? And people who are keto are like, I'm keto. We know it because they tell us, right? Or people who are like, I love cycling. We know it because they tell us when they're not hogging the road. Anyway, this couple from New York Post, biohacking couple plans to live longer than anyone on the planet. Oh, good for you. Nobody cares. So it's this couple and they're doing this, this profile for the New York Post. And I guess they had a photographer come to their house. I'm going to tell you something. If your house is all white and it looks like it's been staged, I think you're crazy. I don't trust you. Nobody's house looks like that. Your house should look lived in. Okay. It shouldn't look like a doctor's waiting room. So they say they're from the Midwest and they want to live longer than anyone on the planet. I'm sure they're very nice. They're the Lentzes, right? One of them was a chief revenue officer at a marketing agency. Somebody else founded a talent agency. I don't know. They sound like your typical couple on House Hunters. Well, I make miniature dollhouse furniture. Yes, and I do underwater basket weaving. We have a budget of $50 million. Like, that's what they sound like, right? So I just need to share this with you. So they were talking about how they got together even. So he started as the biohacker. The guy was the biohacker first, right? They want to live to 150 years old. And they spend six figures a year on their quest for longevity. I don't know who likes this world enough to want to live that long, right? All your friends are dead. You're going to be stuck with Zoomers. I'm sorry, guys, but just saying. It's that time again. Students are returning to school, and I want to share a fantastic learning opportunity with you. So as part of the most informed audience on TV, you'll be pleased to know that the folks over at Hillsdale College have launched the Hillsdale College Podcast Network. This network offers top quality content that delves into education and liberty issues. You and your family can enrich your knowledge by tuning in to lectures and educational podcasts like Radio Free Hillsdale Hour, the Hillsdale College Online Courses Podcast, Imprimis and Hillsdale College K-12 Classical Education Podcast. You'll also find special content from Hillsdale's President Larry Arn. Listen together at home while taking a walk or driving to school or work. With over 2 million downloads, the Hillsdale College Podcast Network is a great way to stay informed. You can find the Hillsdale College Podcast Network on all major podcast platforms. Explore and pick your new favorite podcast today at dana4hillsdale.com. That's dana4hillsdale.com. So she's like, the wife is like, I've been committed to wellness for years. And when I met my husband in person, he asked her for detailed information about health and biology because he wanted to make sure that they were going to be suitable to each other for over a century. What? So, yeah, that's what they did. He made sure that They had to pass all the tests. She had to pass the medical and metaphorical tests, according to the Independent. The pair follow a strict daily routine. It sounds like there's no fun at all. So they wake up. He wakes up before her, and they both begin their day with pulsed electromagnetic field therapy using the clinical-grade device in their home. They follow that up with a workout and a walk to soak up a bit of sunlight as soon as it rises. Then they sit down for an organic homemade breakfast. In the afternoon, they try to get more sun and take a cold plunge if the man works from home. Then they use the hyperbaric oxygen chamber and NanoV, a device that claims to repair everyday cell damage. And for dinner, because apparently they don't eat lunch, she cooks an organic dinner where she sits down to eat with her husband at 5:30 p.m. They take a long walk through the hills, and then they begin their wind-down routine. They do a sauna session and then switch the house to red lights at sunset. They're in bed by 9 p.m. every night. They hope that their strict routine will help them to welcome their first child soon. Well, that's not how that's done, but okay, good for you. They sound like a blast, right? You want to go have some organic quinoa and cicadas over at the Lenses and sit in their red lights? Wouldn't it be like sitting under them fryer lights at a fast food place? I feel like this goes too far. Am I wrong, Kane? Does this go too far? They actually have a cold tub day. The only time I get into cold water is accidentally.
There's health benefits to it.
I don't care. I don't want to live to be 150 at all. I have zero interest.
Yeah, those are the years where someone else...
Have you looked around and seen stuff? People are wearing high-waisted jeans and they want a frayed hem. It's horrible. Have you listened to the music? Have you seen what they're trying to get you to eat? They're putting all this bug stuff in your food. Who the hell wants to live to 150? Take me back to the days when grandma used to put the bacon grease in a jar under the sink and everybody drank. Take me back. I'm just saying. You don't want to live to 150, do you?
No. Where someone else has to like wipe your butt and stuff. Those are the years that I'm not interested in experiencing.
I mean, they literally hold their faces up against this wall of red light, little bubble lights. It just does not sound fun. And then all their photos, it's just so weird, dude. It's so weird. I don't know what I think about this. I mean, you do you, but it's annoying, isn't it?
They're going to end up like Jimmy Carter watching planes fly by.
Yeah, they're going to be wheeled out there and watching. Oh, my gosh. I had to talk about that because I keep seeing it over and over again. There was another story of this woman who was like, oh, I'm a biohacker and I have 11 grandkids. You're not a biohacker. You just eat healthy, Cynthia. Come on. That's not biohacking. Stop it. I can't, man. But I'd rather have those people live into 150 than like Jimmy Carter, right? Yeah. Dana, that's so mean. Thanks for watching The Dana Show. Make sure to like, subscribe, ring the bell, and stay tuned for more content.